The push is one of the primal patterns that allow us to push heavy loads. Start by positioning your body in front of a wall. Move away about 3 feet from that, or as much as you feel that you can handle. If you haven't done any push-ups in a long time, this is a good way to get started with them. The goal for us is to really have a good alignment and proper engagement of your shoulder blades. Many times we accommodate our bodies the wrong way, and we follow our present patterns that we have, causing a lot of disturbances on the rotator calf, especially on the front part of our shoulder. So please make sure to accommodate your, to position your hands right underneath your shoulders in the direction of your shoulders as you do that exercise there. Another position that we assume when we're doing the push-up, it is we sway our backs, we excessively arch the lower back. And also when we don't have the proper range of motion on our wrist, elbows, and shoulders, we look for ways to accommodate different positions of our body. So integrate your body by engaging your glutes, your lower abdominals, and move your whole body as a unit. You don't have to go that deep at the beginning if you have restrictions on your elbows or shoulders or wrist. The kneeling push-up, it will give you a little more resistance as you do that. And again, look at the position of my hands. I'm looking for my hands to be right underneath my shoulders. And the key here, again, is for you to integrate your inner abdominals to connect your hips as a unit. See, if you don't do that, your arch is going to sway, and you're going to be doing a different motion. It feels like if you're doing a push-up, but really, you're just really overstretching the shoulders that ultimately will cause an injury and the rotator calf. We see that many times. Mind-body motion, we treated many shoulder injuries due to the wrong position of their hands and overdoing when indulging in too many repetitions. So making sure you don't rotate your hands at work and your elbows flare up. So engaging your lats is going to be very key for you to do this exercise here. And that allows the chest muscles to stretch a little better. Well, much better the right way. Using the stick on your back, if somebody can help you to give you feedback, it will be ultimately the best way to perform this exercise in an advanced version. Because now you're going to be creating a bridge from your toes to your hands, and your entire body should be streamlined the best way that you can. Okay? So do the exercise slowly, keeping your spine straight. It will be very key for this exercise. Start by doing 3 to 5 repetitions to begin with, 2 to 4 sets, and continuing on moving with this in this position and build up from there. Please leave us a comment. Give us some thumbs up there if you like this exercise. We'll see you soon.